That's Kareem on the radio.
Hamdi, answer me. What's going on out there? You get lost? Get your asses back here then. Gabriel's Estate 5. Come in through the basement. Is that you, Ozan?
Thank you. where you're going? This ain't over!
Kareem, it's Crane. Drop your weapon or you're dead.
What the hell's your problem? This doesn't concern you.
Sorry, Kareem, but Errol Asani is my concern.
You're working for him? You're a fool. I was his bodyguard, okay? After everything got fucked up and they built the wall, we got overrun. He got bitten on the leg. I took him to Randall, the only doctor I knew in the slums, and we cut it off, clean. It was the only way. He would have turned if we hadn't done it. But the stubborn bastard never forgave us. So we parted ways.
So why are you trying to track him down now?
Early on, the authorities evac'd all the political bigwigs out of the zone. Errol told us there was a chopper on the way to take us out with him. Then he got bitten, and with all the shit that happened after that, we missed the flight. But after you turned on the transmitter, we heard Errol asking for evac. And a couple of days ago, somebody responded. From outside. The old bastard's got a flight out, and I want a seat on it.
All right, what about Rice? Does he care about this guy?
Not a rat's ass. This was my business. I just want to get out of Haran.
Yeah, well, looks like you won't be making that flight, huh?
That had already dawned on me. But I'd like to walk out of here.
Look, if I see you again, I'm gonna assume the worst. You got it?
Fair enough. Good luck, Crane. You're going to need it.
Thank you.
are your batteries?
Better check them for bite marks. Well done.
Well, no problems with the counting part of the mission?
How much more do you need to do on this project of yours?
None of your business. Goodbye.
Did you find them?
Yeah, I did. Kareem's take on losing your leg was a bit different than yours.
So, you talked to him. Edward was right. You do talk too much. You should leave the talking to people like me, and I'll leave the killing to people like you. However, Kareem was my bodyguard. He allowed me to get bitten, but I don't really blame him for that.
Hey, he saved your life.
By hacking off my leg? The morning I was bitten was the same day they began dropping suppressants. You understand? I told him the antizin drops would begin within hours. All they had to do was wait. Instead, he listened to that idiot doctor of his, and Kareem held me down as the butcher chopped off my leg. Now he thinks I should fly him out of here.
Yeah, well, I told him that's not gonna happen.
You should have killed him.
How about you leave the killing to people like me, huh?
Quite right. I can get you out of here, Crane.
Maybe I like it here.
More likely you've made your own arrangements. Well, they won't work. You've been bitten. I can see it in your eyes. You'll never get past the NCOR quarantine.
Past what?
You see, you have no idea what's going on in the real world. Whoever you think you know, they're not political. And that's the only thing that's going to work now. You don't believe me? Then think of it as an ace up your sleeve. A backup plan. In case you haven't noticed, things don't always work out the way they're supposed to in this town.
Right. If I'm interested, what happens next?
Two things. The first is we need to paint some markers on the rooftop. There's no paint around here, so you'll have to go out and find some. And the second thing is... well, let's just say you'll be leaving here in a better way than when you arrived. Now, go find some paint. There's a construction site nearby. You should look there. I'll tell you the next task when you've completed the first. Trust me, you're going to be very satisfied with the outcome.